Hello everyone, Robert here from European Watch Company. And today, we're gonna talk about subs.
Not those subs!
The Rolex Submariner, a watch all of you have heard about, and I'm sure all of you have seen videos on it. There's a ton of videos about Rolex subs on the internet. So I wanted to take a little bit of a different approach to this one here. I do have a couple subs from different eras here with me that I'm gonna show you. But I wanted to talk more in general about the design of this watch and why this watch is what it is today. Historically, you could argue that it is one of, if not the most important wristwatch. I think when many people think of Rolex, the thing that they immediately picture in their mind is a Rolex sub. So where did it come from? It started in the 50s in 1953. Rolex introduced the 6202, which I don't have on hand, but we'll put a picture of that right here. And that watch was a turnograph. So it was one of their kind of standard models, but with the addition of a rotating bezel. And this was the first time we saw a rotating bezel on a serially produced watch. Previous to this, you found it maybe on the zero graph, but only a handful of those were made. So many consider this to be the first watch with that kind of functioning bezel. And of course, without that, you wouldn't have things like the GMT Master or many of the other watches we now look at today where that is a very common feature. So when you look at subs, it's a watch where you will always recognize exactly what it is. You have, even within these eras here, which span from 1959 all the way up into the modern era, you have your black dial, you have your Mercedes hands, you have luminous indices, that rotating bezel, and a pretty rugged stainless steel case. And I think the appeal of this watch ultimately is the ultimate versatility of it. It works with pretty much everything. You know, we see James Bond wearing them with tuxedos all the way down to people diving with them over top of the wetsuit. Watches that were designed as a tool watch and to be used in the water, but something that was also made to the absolute highest quality, which is also why we have examples like this from 1959 with the original dial and the original radium still intact. And this watch probably was used because people, when they bought these back then, they didn't look at it as I'm buying this priceless timepiece. This was something where it was like, I want a really good watch that I can wear and I can work and I can take in the water. And they probably did that. The other thing that I think is really important is that Rolex has managed to keep their design consistent while still updating it. I often liken it to the Porsche 911. If you see a 911 from any era, you know exactly what that car is because they have maintained the shape and the lines and the character of that car. And because of that, it's become one of those iconic vehicles. The Submariner is the same thing. If we look at this watch from 53, or if we move into the 60s here, and arguably into the 70s with the 5513s and the 5512s, we still have a plastic domed crystal, but other than that, they pretty much look like our modern counterparts. You move into the 90s, I guess the 80s if you think about the transitional references like the 16800, but you move into that era and you start getting sapphire crystal and you start getting a hacking seconds mechanism, you get a quick set date, you get more water resistance because the technology gets better. And so Rolex continues to improve this watch without completely reinventing it. And that, I think, is really the secret to Rolex having the legacy that it does. You move into the modern era, and the material science gets even better. And you get a ceramic bezel, which won't fade or discolor like on the one from the 50s here where some of the paint is missing, or, you know, we see things like ghost bezels and things like that, which some people like. Other people look for the ones that stay looking brand new. And that's ultimately what these ceramic bezel pieces are going to do as well. And now the lume on these is incredibly bright. The new luminous material that Rolex is using, super luminova and chromolite and things like that, are incredible. And so I think their ability to upgrade the watch without messing it up is a really key skill that not every watchmaker has.